Not for Sale is my fifth book. I've written other books, but this book really got under my skin in a different kind of way. Watching and observing the people who are in slavery, getting to know them, and getting to know the abolitionists, the real life heroes who today are doing something to end slavery. It became much more emotionally and spiritually challenging than anything I've ever done before. I got to know their stories. They shared with me and opened their lives, and I wanted to chronicle that in this book. But I didn't want to just tell the story of, you know, a gloom and doom. You know, we hear so many stories about global warming and global poverty, and we all feel like we can't do anything. Well, we can stop trafficking. There's very practical things that we can do, and that's what I tried to capture in this book. I told the stories of people who are making a difference. And I found that anyone can make a difference. A student in Rhode Island at Brown University starting an international abolitionist movement. A telephone worker in Virginia saving six kids who he just stumbled upon who were in slavery. A lawyer who quit the Justice Department so he could work full time on helping people get free from slavery all over the world. These are abolitionists that are active today, and they're making a difference. And after writing this book, it became much more than just an academic exercise or yet another book that I could, you know, put away and start a new chronicle in my life. I decided that this was a calling for me. I dreamed about it. I thought about it all day. And now I'm putting aside all my other projects and I'm focusing on abolitionist work, the Not For Sale campaign, because I think that we together can make a difference.